An examination of the impact of NOAA's habituation programs on the Hawaiian monk seal, 1997 through 2014. Main focus will be the habituating of a molting monk seal and its friend. June 2014, Black Rock, Maui. Fair use notice. The following may contain copyrighted materials made available to advance understanding. It is believed that this constitutes a fair use of any such copyrighted material as provided for in Section 107 of the U.S. copyright laws. This video will take a close look at the impact of the Maui Marine Mammal Response Program on the behavior of the Hawaiian monk seal on Maui. Habituate means to accustom an individual either physically or mentally to a particular situation, to train. NOAA has a particular agenda for monk seals. David Schofield will explain his rather bizarre beliefs about what human interaction will do to a monk seal.
We want to remind the public that interacting with the seals or feeding the seals or even making eye contact is detrimental to the behavior and survival of the seals.
The interaction like that has actually caused the naturally docile mammal to become aggressive. Their personality is usually formed during their first year of life.
And they can either go in a pathway of going out to the wild and being wild, or if during that time they interact with people, that's when this habituation and conditioning starts. And then from there they can evolve into adulthood as being, quote, problem seals.
In the video to follow, we will see how people attempt to implement this policy. In my view, the number of births in a given time period is a good indicator of the success or failure of any monk seal program. Under the watchful eye of the Maui response team, there have been 4 births in the last 17 years on Maui. Without the benefit of a response team, there have been 83 births during the same time frame on Kalapapa. These numbers are the direct result of NOAA's efforts to habituate the Hawaiian monk seal. Flashback on the history of habituation on the Hawaiian monk seal, Maui. It's 7 years ago, and we find Surfer Girl hauled out on the rocks adjacent to McKenna State Park. After a few hours of snoozing, Surfer Girl enters the water and heads out to interact with the surfer. The thing to note in this video is that the monk seal Surfer Girl approaches the surfer. The surfer is taken by surprise, and although he tries to ignore the seal will not leave him alone. Surfer Girl, R305, makes a choice and habituates with Surfer to become Problem Seal, October 24th, 2007. It will become clear in this video that this sort of habituation by the Hawaiian monk seal is not acceptable to NOAA. Maui Marine Mammal Response Program Coordinator Nicole Davis on her way to Little Beach to instruct about monk seals. Nicole told people this was an impressionable young female and they need to avoid eye contact and leave her alone. I advised Nicole that many an impressionable young female approach this particular surfer dude. It is important to note that in these examples, it is the seal that initiates the human interaction. It's 7 years later, and we find surfer girl R305 hauled out at Black Rock in the process of molting. This is my old friend Surfer Girl, and we're going to zoom in and check her out in what's probably her first day of starting to molt. We're going to zoom in here and get a really close look at her chest, and you can see how the fur is starting to peel off. Think of her as molting or shedding her skin like a snake. That's the way they do it. This process is termed a catastrophic molt, and it will take a few days. And we're going to be on hand to observe that process from beginning to end. Some roughness on the top of the back suggests the molting process is underway, but it's not as apparent as it was on the belly that we looked at a moment ago. Here's another view angle, and we're going to zoom in and be looking at the back of the monk seal. Zooming in, you can see the individual hairs on the back of this monk seal. That's funny. This monk seal has ears. Note that my camera has a 70x zoom lens and can zoom in from the distance of 150 feet suggested by NOAA. This lady probably doesn't have the 70x zoom lens and has to get as close as she can to get any sort of decent picture of the monk seal at all. Looking from the back of the monk seal, the skin looks pretty uniform here and we don't really see signs of the molt. Here's another view of the head of the monk seal after it's been immersed in water, and the molting is not as apparent. Continuing to scan down the belly of the monk seal, it looks like the molt is progressing. Watching a monk seal molt is slightly more exciting than watching paint dry. Well, at least to some people. Keep this view of a full body flex in mind and compare it with ones taken later during the molt. It's quite interesting. It's about 9:20 on the second day of the molt, and we're looking for the seal, and the seal's not here. To my knowledge, R305 had not hauled out to this location in the past to molt. Certainly, she is not wedded to this location and does not need or expect to be reserved for her use. She actually comes ashore to interact with people. Actions by NOAA's volunteers to attempt to habituate the monk seal to a particular portion of the beach and to interfere with the seal's interaction with humans is in contravention of the Endangered Species Act. Under state law, it may be considered a take and classified as a felony. The disparity between the births on Maui and the births at Kalaupapa is a manifestation of the negative impact on the monk seal by the activity of the volunteers. Interview with scuba divers, June 2, 2014, describing their encounter earlier in the day. The seal discussed is presumed to be Surfer Girl R305, the larger molting seal. All right, the camera's running. Why don't you tell me your name and...
Eric Nordstrom. I live here on Maui as a dive guide.
Oh, great.
My name is Tony Kobian, and I'm here visiting my mother, who lives in Kula. And
you just had an experience with a monk seal, and you're going to tell me about it.
Amazing experience with a monk seal, and we saw her on the beach over there, and which was really cool in just in itself. And then we went, began to swim around a black rock here and saw all kinds of amazing sights and swam with hundreds of goatfish. And then a turtle came swimming by. The turtle kind of hung out for a little while. And lo and behold, just as soon as the turtle kind of went into the blue of the ocean, up to our right came the monk seal. And it was pretty amazing. We were fortunate enough, she kind of, by her own choice, she swam up right by us and was kind of, you know, it almost felt like a little wave. It was waved its arm, its fin at it. I don't know what it is.
Flipper, I think.
Flipper, there we go. Flipper, sorry. Shows mine out. And then it started rubbing its eyes because it was just waking up from its little sleep on the beach. So it was really, really special.
I was telling him how unbelievably lucky he is. there are a lot of people. I've got a few hundred dives here on Maui. I've never been in the water except for this one when she was sleeping in the cave here at Black Rock. Saw her for the past couple weeks. But this is by far the closest one's ever gotten to me.
And you saw her in the cave around the corner here.
Yeah, for probably a couple weeks now we've been finding her. There's a nice sized cave down here.
Is it the same one, you believe?
Yeah, we're pretty sure that's the same one that has now decided to start molting here on the beach. So yeah, it was really special. Around 1,100 of them left in the world, I think.
Supposedly 1,100 and about 150 in the main Hawaiian Islands.
It's really special getting to see a highly endangered animal in its own environment. Yeah, it's one of the amazing things with scuba diving. It's the reason I love it.
Fantastic. Well, great commentary. Thank you very much for that.
Yeah, pleasure.
It's 8:22 a.m. on day 3, and we're watching our molting monk seal. We're zooming in from the side. It's in shadow, but we can see a little top knot of its head there exposed. We're going to zoom on down the side here, and if you look closely, you can see some of the, I don't know what you call it, defoliation. I don't think that's the right term. You can see some of the fur breaking off down there on the lower edge. It's in shadow, so we'll get another shot of it later, but you get the idea. It's starting to pull off, mainly on the belly. Some roughness on the side. Another closer look at that spot on the top of its head where the fur has departed. We drop back and we can see that the response team is actually interfering with the natural behavior of the monk seal in contradiction of both federal and state law. Here's a close-in look at the backside of the monk seal, and you can see some disruptions there. Again, very early stages of shedding. Another view from the side. We're going to zoom in and we've got great lighting. The state of the molt really shows up on this particular video. Pay particular attention to the area just behind the front flipper there. You can see it's slightly gray. That's the fresh molt area. I'm going to give you a heads up as to what to watch for here in the molt progression of a monk seal. Believe it or not, but you're going to see it in this video, this gray area by the flipper and on the belly is going to turn to white later on when the molting is completed. In the top of the seal, it's going to turn to a slate gray. Most amazing. A NOAA spokesperson will articulate a philosophy that will justify taking the young monk seal from Maui.
dangerous to humans.
It is certainly a concern for public safety. This animal is young. She probably weighs about 200 pounds now, but she's growing and she may double that over the next several years. And that's something quite frightening to encounter in the water.
Interview with Snorkeler, June 3rd, 2014. The seal discussed is presumed to be Surfer Girl R305, the larger molting seal. Notice how the seal is described as approaching and intruding into the couple's space.
All right, the camera is rolling. Would you tell me your name, please?
Hi, my name's Lynn Cavalheim. I'm from Southern California.
Okay, and do I have your permission to post this on YouTube?
You do.
All right, and you've had an experience with this seal that we see in the background here. Are you going to tell us about it?
Sure. Yesterday, my husband and I were out snorkeling on the back side of Black Rock. We went out probably around 9:30, quarter of 10 in the morning. And as we were making our way back towards this beach, the seal just popped up between us, surprised us. We weren't looking for her, but I suddenly saw a large gray shape sleeking through the water towards me, and it was a bit of a surprise, but she seemed completely comfortable with us. We backed off and tried to give her space, but she nosed in between us. She came to the surface a couple of times. She had a yellow fish in her mouth that she seemed more interested in playing with and eating, but we hovered above her for about 20 minutes, and she would stay down for a long time, which surprised me. I didn't know that seals had the capacity to stay underwater for such an extended period of time. But she would dive under an underwater sea ledge and play with her catch. And the only reason we could keep tabs on her was because the flash of the yellow fish in the water would alert us to her presence down there.
And you mentioned there were a couple of two or three scuba divers in the water below you that you don't think even saw the seal.
No, I think it's a shame because the divers, it appeared to us that there was a couple probably with an instructor, a guide. The guide was in front of them and he had missed the seal completely, and they were on the ocean floor and the seal was above them playing on the surface. And just as they were leaving the area, the seal took a dive down to that ledge, and the two, the couple, the divers, noticed her and we could tell they were pointing her out. But their guide had moved on, and so they, I think, were reluctant to stay in the area without their teacher, so they moved on. But we hovered above the seal for a while and finally decided to give her some space.
What do you think of this encounter? Are you enjoying it?
It was amazing to me. I'm a certified diver. I've been diving for probably 35 years, off the coast of California most of the time. I've only encountered a seal one other time, and that was in California. Probably it was a gray.
And that was
seal.
In California, and
it was
only
in California.
Once. That's
just the
surprising.
One time. So I've snorkeled and even dove off the waters here in Maui, and I've never seen a seal in the water before here, so it was quite a unique experience. I understand from the volunteer that's here that this is the only place in the world where the Hawaiian monk seal exists, and that they're solitary creatures. She said she's molting.
She is molting.
She's,
I believe,
coming
she
up
had
and
a...
resting on the beach, I guess, preparing for that.
Well, they do a lot of time with the molt. She had a pup, I believe, the end of March, and over in Koholave. And she would nurse that pup for about 50 days.
Wow.
And then which would take it up to last month. And then a short time after that, they do this molt. This is called a catastrophic molt. They shed their entire skin.
Oh, wow.
It's just like a snake shedding its skin. It's quite fascinating.
Yes, I think you can tell by looking at her that she's shedding her skin. But in the water, it wasn't as obvious yesterday. She looked very sleek.
Well, it's progressing. A day or so ago when I saw her, it wasn't this extensive. And in fact, that's why I came back. I wanted to see how it progressed.
Well, I took this walk down the beach this morning because I was hoping she might be up here. I had heard from the concierge in our condominium complex that she'd been hanging around the beach for a week or so. And so I thought, well, maybe she did come up to rest. I was lucky.
You were. Very great interview. Thank you very much.
Thank you for your time.
You're welcome.
An outrigger canoe cruises by and everybody on board gets a good view. of the Hawaiian monk seal molting. Another close-in view of the front flipper and the side of the seal. Keep in mind this is going to change to a white. Also note that the skin is peeling off on the flipper. Quite amazing. It's day three and Surfer Girl gets ready to take off and head out. We're going to get a good look at her side profile and see how this molt is coming along. And it's a view from up above, and you can see adjacent to that swimmer something is underwater and swimming about. It could be a monk seal. Turns out it's not. Actually, it's a couple of sea turtles, but from my vantage point, and well, here's another view. This is a solitary sea turtle, but you get the idea. A monk seal looks very similar. But we didn't see the monk seal. It's later in the afternoon on day three of the molt, about 3:23, and Surfer Girl has returned and is hauled out. Good side view. From this side view, the molt doesn't seem to be very apparent at all. As we zoom in, we can see some roughness that's associated with the molt. But the skin is pretty much intact. We zoom in on this headshot and we can see the top of the head and we can see how the skin is peeled off, showing us a balding monk seal. Well, not really balding. A close-up face shot from the other side and you can see some of the detail in the molting of the facial skin. More of a head-on view of the monk seal, and you can see some of the molding, particularly behind that front flipper to the viewer's left. Now we zoom in on the face, and you can see the wrinkles and textures associated with the molt that's in progress. Top of the head is free of skin, but the surrounding area is not. The old skin is gone from the top of the head. The new skin has a dusting of sand. We've got a view of the belly of the beast, so to speak. Look how it's sort of a light gray. Keep in mind, this is going to turn to white. Hard to believe, huh? Here's a closer zoom in. A monk seal protector guards an approach to the seal from water. An hour later, and the monk seal still has its head pointed toward the water and is sacked out. It's morning of day four, and our monk seal is on the beach. We've zoomed in, and we can see some signs of the molting occurring on the top of the seal. The new fur is growing in from below and forcing the old skin off of the seal. From the other side with a different sun angle. Another view angle and we can see the old fur has sloughed off right behind the flipper. Another view angle and we can see how the belly has become much more exposed. I feel compelled to say that this monk seal sticking its head in the sand is rather normal behavior and has nothing to do with the molt. It's afternoon of day 4 and a good belly shot shows the extent of the molt on the bottom of this creature. Do note the silver-gray color. Another great belly shot, and we can see how much more has been exposed. Now we're looking at the side, and we can see that not a whole lot more has been exposed in that area. This rollover will give you a neat perspective on the entire creature. How about that? Note again how the belly is very gray and extensive. Now we're back to the top. Early evening on day 4 and a guest seal has appeared. The notorious RL06. RL06 is a 2-year-old daughter of RO17, Lona. She was born on Kalapapa on July 20th, 2012. Here is a shot of RL06, 17 days old, with its mom, Lona. Here is another shot of Lona's pup, 47 days old. You're not going to believe this. Listen to what the pup says.
Noah.
Lona's pup clearly says Noah to me in September of 2012. Is this prophetic or what? Is this acknowledging the role that this pup is going to play in the liberation of monk seals in the main Hawaiian islands? It's the next morning. It's day 5 in the molt, and we find we have our two seals together. Presumably, RL06 spent the night with R305. A member of the response team seems to be gesturing to this female in the water that she has to leave the area. I can't imagine what the problem is here, for the woman is so far from the seals. The monk seals are puzzled by this behavior. For they know that if they want to interact with this person face to face, all they have to do is slide into the water and have that interaction. Additionally, the seals are telepathically aware of the altercation. The seals' efforts to avoid this sort of negative energy may explain why they go to Kalapapa to birth. Since 1997, there have been 4 births on Maui. Well, over on Kalapapa, there have been 83. Yes, that's right, 83. A close-in shot of the rear flippers gives us an opportunity to read the tags. Younger seals are more likely to have a tag. Older seals may have had their tag fall off, or in all likelihood never had a tag. The volunteer to our right is getting his tag shot so that he can confirm this is indeed the seal that is the focal point of their assault. Another look at Surfer Girl's bottom, and she's basically slate gray from head to toe with fringes of skin around the sides and upper back. The effect of the molt is becoming quite obvious. The color patterns of this head-on shot make this one of my favorite shots of a monk seal in the process of molting. Again, keep in mind what I've been telling you. This seal is going to be white on the bottom and dark slate gray on the top before long. Here's a view from the other end, and you can get a contrasting look at how the seal looks from behind. It's the end of the day on molt day 5, and basically what we see is just a recap of what we saw in the earlier morning presentation. A view of RL06, Snoozen, some views of R305. Another flashback. We're down at Oluwalu, March 30th, 2013. We're looking at R305's daughter. This is T02 or 03, depending on which tag you're looking at, born on Koho'olawe. Another example of mother seals being driven away from Maui by NOAA activities. This is a significant clip. This is what monk seals do. She will bop down here to snooze for maybe up to 8 minutes, and then she will pop up to the surface for a couple minutes. Apparently, this is what monk seals do when they're not habituating with humans or out trying to catch a meal. This is another example of habituated seals playing with humans. This is another example of normal behavior for a seal of this age. They just come this way, habituated, believe it or not. It's a fact. The only seals that don't habituate with people are dead seals. Understand that, and you know the whole underpinning of the current NOAA monk seal protection plan. They are going to stop monk seals from habituating with humans, even if they have to kill every last one of them to achieve this objective. Remember, there were 3,000 in the mid-70s. Today, there are 1,100.
The paddle, I need it. I need that.
I understand this seal was targeted for extraction and removal from the area. Fortunately, NOAA was unable to capture her. NOAA has been quite successful in utilizing volunteers to disrupt the relationship between monk seals and humans. Some volunteers have no idea of the amount of damage they are doing to the monk seal population. Others are quite cognizant of the impact on the monk seal and are very happy to be a part of it. Their goal, apparently, is to eliminate the monk seal from the Hawaiian Islands.
Are you getting any video?
So much for habituating RT03, returning to R305. We find R305, Surfer Girl, hauled out with RL06, Lona's kit. We see the protection crew keeping a few visitors at bay, otherwise a quiet afternoon at the beach. It's day 6 in the molt, and the only seal on the beach is R305. A zoom in shows a bit of fur on the top of her back, but more and more she's getting devoid of fur. It's about 7:30 on day 6, and Surfer Girl is making a break for it. She's going in the water, get out of here. Gives us a great opportunity to see the side and how this mold is coming along, and it's obviously progressing rather nicely. Won't be long now, and she'll be devoid of her old skin. Checking the beach on late afternoon on day 6 of the molt, we find Surfer Girl is on shore, belly up, and very smooth and sleek looking. She does a rollover, and we see her back, and we see that the area covered by old fur is much smaller than it had been before. The molt is progressing nicely. There is a marked contrast between how Surfer Girl looked this morning on her right side when she went in the water and how she looks this afternoon when she's been out of the water. Look at the difference. Quite remarkable. The verbal assault on the monk seal is sustained by the volunteers incessantly. Only after dark are the seals free from attack. Note that the top of the back of the seal is starting to turn that slate gray that I told you about, and it also appears the belly is starting to get a little white. It's time for another one of those rollover views. Look at the belly, devoid of fur, old fur that is, and pretty white. Rolls over, look at that back. It's got a patch of fur on the back, but it's slate gray. It's morning, day 7, and Surfer Girl is on the beach. And we're going to look her over from head to toe and find that she's just about finished with the molding process. There are some little tidbits on her top of her back toward the south end of her, but that's about it as far as I can see. It's late afternoon on day 7 of the molt, and Surfer Girl has been joined by her friend RL06. Remember what I said about the belly going from that light gray to white? Well, doesn't that look alabaster to you? Looking at the kid, she looks a little rough too. You wonder just when she's going to start molting, or perhaps she already has started. It's morning, day 8 of the molt, and Surfer Girl is the only one on the beach today. Scan over to my right to see the barriers being placed up to keep people away from the seal. I had seen this end of the beach totally closed off by other volunteers. This team is going to create a narrow gauntlet of rocks so that you can pass behind the seal. It will force scuba divers entering the water to walk to the north to get behind the seal before they can enter the beach. And you can see here the walk path is not easy. The seal would not be bothered by the scuba divers walking over the rocks and right down to the water alongside the seal. They would just snooze through it, no problem. The volunteers are well aware of this, I've come to believe, but they really enjoy their sense of power and controlling how people are forced to stay away from the monk seal. Here we actually catch a couple of scuba divers coming in and having to climb over the rocks and having to do it very carefully. I have to say I actually sprained my knee in the process of moving about these rocks. Good morning. She's waiting for you.
I know. She looks pretty comfortable, huh?
Yeah. She's going to come out and join you for a swim.
Yeah, I hope.
That would be way cool.
Has that happened to you before?
It has. She sleeps right down here. She's always down here.
Where's the ledge? Is it right here?
Yeah, it's right around this a little bit. So.
It's around? It's not visible from this angle? This is Nicole Davis, coordinator of the Maui Marine Mammal Response Program. Whenever I see Nicole, I offer an opportunity for her to make some comment on the record. She always declines. It's just about midday on molt day 10. And we find Surfer Girl coming in from the surf. Wow, how about that? She is very pretty and slate gray on the top, white on the bottom, just like we mentioned early on in this video. On the beach, we find Lona's 2-year-old daughter chilling out. Seal protectors harangue the people in the water and tell them that there's a problem unless they get out of the water. Note the reality of the situation. Surfer Girl has returned to shore and is not intimidated by the people in the water. Seal protectors do what they can to disrupt the viewscape of the viewing public. An informational sign is added explaining that the seal is sleeping.
Divers find that they can take a more direct path to the water and walk by the seals. Seals acknowledge the divers and go back to what they were doing. Video by Keith Sadler showing typical monk seal behavior, which is intentionally misconstrued by NOAA spokesperson. This same video will be shown on local TV as documenting an aggressive monk seal. The divers I've talked to enjoy this sort of interaction with the monk seal. It is one of their most enjoyable interactions with a seal they've ever had in their life. Not a reason to remove it from the breeding population.
Much. And now here's video you'll only see on Hawaii News Now. It's an aggressive monk seal biting and grabbing divers off Maui. Now the seal's being sent far away for our own good. Lisa Kubota has the exclusive details from Ford Island.
RL06 was moved from Ka'anapali here to Ford Island on Friday. In a few days, her new home will be in the northwestern Hawaiian Islands. This video taken near Black Rock in Ka'anapali shows RL06 trying to play with some divers. But the two-year-old's behavior can be dangerous to humans.
It is certainly a concern for public safety. This animal is young. She probably weighs about 200 pounds now, but she's growing and she may double that over the next several years. And that's something quite frightening to encounter in the water.
For more than a year, scientists have heard about her close encounters with people off West Maui. But recently, her actions have become more aggressive.
Those escalated behaviors include things like latching on to people's legs with her front flippers, preventing people from exiting the water, and also nipping on a couple of occasions.
Researchers managed to capture her on Friday. They say it's too late to change her behavior, so they decided to move her far away from people. A NOAA research ship happened to be leaving for the northwestern Hawaiian Islands, so workers loaded her onto the Hi'ialakai for the voyage.
It's hugely disappointing when we have to do this because the actions are a direct result of human activities, and we need folks to be responsible around seals, so not approaching them.
RL06 will be traveling about 1,000 miles to join other endangered Hawaiian monk seals at Laysan Island.
Seals seem to be very charismatic animals, and it's natural for us to want to be close to them or capture some special photograph with them, but those are actually very damaging, harmful things to do for a seal's wild nature.
RL06 is expected to arrive at Laysan Island on Saturday. She's been equipped with a satellite tag so that researchers can track her movements for a while. Reporting from Ford Island, Lisa Kubota, Hawaii News Now.
Imagine she'll...
Problems from RL06 from relocation. Removed from known foraging area. Likely to suffer stunted growth. Removed from birth beach. In another 2 years would likely return to birth beach to have first of many pups. Expectation based on NOAA's data, she will disappear. Removed from extended family, will have to establish place in local peck order. Prospects for survival, let alone reproduction, are not good. Further documentation of NOAA's efforts to eliminate the Hawaiian monk seal from the main Hawaiian island.
We have an update on a story we first brought you on Tuesday. RL06, the Hawaiian monk seal who had to be moved from Maui because of her aggressive behavior around humans, is now at her new home. Crews dropped off the two-year-old at Laysan Island in the northwestern Hawaiian Islands yesterday. Researchers will continue to monitor her to see how she's socializing with other seals. Officials say at last check, she had a brand new boyfriend. Looks like she's settling in nicely. Coming up.
It is commonly reported that the monk seal is doing well in the main Hawaiian Islands. The fact is that with the exception of situations like Kalapapa, the decline has been exacerbated by NOAA's programs attempting to dictate seal behavior when interacting with people on land or in the water. Conclusions and recommendation. It is a fact that the recent decline in the population among seals is a result of NOAA's lack of understanding of their behavior. They do not recognize that mother seal teach their young to find solid food within days of birth. a process they become quite proficient at by the time they are weaned. NOAA's Maui Marine Mammal Response Program, discussed here, has developed a number of techniques to habituate the seal on a fast track to extinction. Gullible volunteers, thinking they are helping save, are assisting in the decline. The adverse effects of those actions has been documented in this video. Four births Maui versus 83 Molokai, 1997 to 2014. What you can do to help. Point out the irrefutable facts about the damage caused by NOAA's programs. Point out that the recent data dump in the permit review process may obfuscate the facts. It does not change them. NOAA's programs do not work because they do not properly understand seal behavior. A more chilling interpretation is that they do know what they are doing and the decline is desired effect with extinction to follow. For documentation of mother monk seal teaching pup how to find solid food within days of birth, view First 50 Days in the Life of Hawaiian Monk Seal on YouTube. Special thanks, James K. Walsh, PC, Attorney at Law, Eugene, Oregon. Barry Cook, Barry's Ocean Adventures, Lahaina, Hawaii. Until next time, peace be with you.